pandas suck at pandaing. There, I said it. They are literally the worst at being pandas. I could be a better panda than a panda. Hey there, panda pals. Trace here for DNews. Thanks for tuning in. The giant panda is a divisive animal in the DNews office. Some of us think it is the cutest and it's all cuddly, and others think it is the worst thing ever. I think science has finally settled the debate with a new study about the panda, and it turns out they're pretty much just terrible at life. Here's what you probably know about the giant panda already. They're solitary, tree-climbing, black and white mountain bears that only eat bamboo and are notoriously difficult to breed in zoos. All of that is true. But new research from the American Society of Microbiology studied the gut bacteria of the giant panda and found that they're not even good at digesting bamboo, which is the only thing they eat. According to their findings, the giant panda's microbiota are horribly adapted for the diet that the panda consumes, which is just, I just need a minute here. Giant pandas eat bamboo for 14 hours a day. It's one of the fastest growing plants in the world. Some species can grow a meter a day, which is good because pandas are eating 27 and a half pounds of it daily, but they still can't digest it. They only process about 17% of the stuff they're shoving into their maw. This is an incredibly sad and real illustration of evolution's lags. Looking at what bacteria the panda does have reveals the evolutionary history of our favorite black and white bear. Pandas began to exclusively eat bamboo around 2 million years ago. But even so, their gut flora were essentially the same as their carnivorous and omnivorous cousins. Surprisingly, they have not evolved some of the basic bacteria to break down those plant fibers, and yet they eat plants. What the hell, evolution? So, it seems as if it's supposed to eat meat based on the bacteria living inside of its gastrointestinal tract, but it doesn't do it that often. The reason why it doesn't might be answered in another study from PLOS One. The study looked at the genes of the giant panda and found 4.2 million years ago, the giant panda's T1R1 gene mutated, causing them to lose the ability to taste umami, the deliciousness that comes from meats like bacon. Their appetite reward system was forever altered, and this mutated species lost its taste for meat. Literally. Okay, I mean, that's a little hyperbolic. Pandas do eat their occasional small rodent or deer fawn, but scientists believe because of the loss of umami, their herbivorous diet was further reinforced. Funnily enough, herbivores like cows and horses do carry the T1R1 gene, which allows for umami. Scientists are puzzled, to say the least. To add to all of this biological dissonance are the well-documented problems with panda breeding. Females only ovulate once a year for only a couple of days. If the female doesn't meet a male in that time, and they're really solitary, remember, they don't birth any cubs that year. But if they do, the newborn is 1/900th the size of its mother. It's seriously tiny and blind, and it requires feeding every 2 hours when it cries, similar to a human baby. Eventually, they grow and mature, gaining black and white hair that scientists still don't understand, and 3 years later will strike out on their own. Seriously, this is the worst system for being an animal. I don't want them to go extinct, but it sure sounds like the panda just doesn't want a panda, doesn't it? Let's not put the blame entirely on them. Thanks to humans destroying the panda habitat, there are only about 1,000 left in the wild, and maybe 100 in zoos. Because of that, we can learn a lot about them, but man, the more I learn, the more I'm just like, what? Do you love pandas? The black and white ones are great, but I mean like the red ones, the black and white ones, whatever. Tell us down in the comments, and please subscribe so you get more of our videos every day, and we'll see you next time.